afternoon, guys. Hope you're well. This is the tutorial for the dog's eye in pastel pencil and soft pastel. So as you can see now, I'm just laying down the initial sketch. The pencil I'm using is a Derwent Graphic 4B. Ordinarily I would use a HB or something similar, but obviously for this video I thought it'd be easier to use a slightly softer pencil so you can see what I'm laying down. So just constantly looking at the reference photo while I'm doing this. Moving the tracing paper just to stop the graphite getting too messy on the pastel mat. I hope you're all stocked up on your alcohol, by the way. I think I managed to edit the video to about 1¾ hours. So it's going to be a long one. I'm using a very light hand. I'm trying to keep my hand at this stage out of the frame so you can see what I'm actually doing. Obviously the drawing's only 6" by 6", so it doesn't take much for my hand to cover the whole lot. Just drawing out roughly where everything needs to be, obviously the right side of what would be the pupil. And then now I'm going in with the rough shape of my reflection. Like a bloody Dalek or something. This sketch part has been sped up 1.25 times. Obviously you kind of all get the idea of what I'm doing, so I didn't want to send you all to sleep too soon. Getting a rough idea of the shapes and the where lines and whatnot need to be on the whole drawing. You'll see from the video I am spinning my pencil every couple of strokes, and that's purely just to keep the point sharper for longer. Just putting in a rough direction of hair there where the tear duct would be. Obviously, if you don't want to sketch out the piece, then you can use the line art provided in the post before and trace, or you can grid. You don't need to freehand, or freehanded just because I find it the easiest thing to do, to be honest, but I know a lot of people do prefer to use other methods. Nice dirty rubber. As you can see, I don't actually think it did anything. I'm trying to rub my lines out of it, but it just seemed to make more mess than it did actually doing its job. Waste of bloody time that were. Just going back in, adding that line in again. corner of the eye out a fraction there. So now I'm going in with the Faber-Castell Pit Pastel Black 119. Just getting the darkest areas down, so around the iris, below the eyelid, my reflection, just anywhere where it looks like there's a good amount of black basically. So now just going in with the Unison Colour Black Soft Pastel CB2. This is just going over the darkest areas of the piece. It's a fair bit more pigmented than the Faber-Castell Pit Pastel, so this is getting me the darkest values all I need. Now the terracotta like pastel. pastel is a Unison Colours Soft Pastel Red Earth 17. At least I think that's what it is. Any soft pastel similar will do. You know what I mean? It's just like a terracotta-y brownie. Anything similar will work fine. Just getting a rough idea of what colours go where at the minute. That is the Caran d'Ache Raw Russet 788066. Like a rusty red sort of colour. Going in there with the Faber-Castell Pit Pastel, Pastel Bistro 179. And just getting all the basic colours down. This will all be muted down as I go along, so it's very much just the undertones. No detail or finesse needed. Just looking at my reference photo. Getting colours down where I see them. Going in with the, what colour is it? Helio Turquoise 155. Just getting that, starting the reflection in. Again, you don't need to use the exact colours I'm using, that's just a reference. If you've not got any of the colours or you want to use a different colour, then go for it, do you know what I mean? It's only a drawing, so. Do as you wish, guys. Just moving areas down a little bit there with the black. Scumbling across the surface. Putting a little bit of dark in there just from the edge of the iris. Now going in with a cotton bud, and this is just to soften everything out. Very light hand at this stage. You will see there is a bit of detail still left once I've gone over the whole piece. But you do have to think this is still very much the base layer, so don't panic if it's not looking exactly the same or if there's areas that need tweaking. At the end of the day, you've still got loads of layers to go, so don't worry about details, etc, etc. Pulling that black into the light area just to mute the colours down. Re-establishing a bit of that blue there, say blue turquoise. Now going in with the Faber-Castell Pit Pastel White, which is, what number are we on, 101. Getting my brightest highlights down now because they are extra extremely bright, so if I get them down early, they're sort of done and give me the strongest value to work from. Just scumbling across the pastel mat there, again, just getting a rough idea of where things are going. And now going in with the Faber-Castell Cream 102, just to soften that white down a bit. Just the base there for a couple of highlights at the top of the eye, and that's more just so I don't forget towards the end of the piece. Back in with that cream, just getting a bit of colour down on the actual eyeball itself. In with the bistro. Now this one is a Faber-Castell Medium Flesh 131. Again, just as I've been doing throughout the whole video, I'm just drawing what I'm seeing. I'm not worrying about accuracy at this point. In with the cream. And this is a Faber-Castell Pit Pastel Pencil Ivory, and the number is 103. Again, looking at the reference photo, so I know that the areas I'm drawing at the minute are quite bright, so giving them a good bit of colour straight away. Now this one is a Caran d'Ache Violet Grey 788093. Nice purpley, fleshy sort of tone. That bistro again, just to mute it down. one is the Faber-Castell Pit Pastel Scarlet Red 118. Just getting the lightest part of my top in there. Now, if I remember correctly, at this stage, I dabbed the cotton bud. Dabbed the cotton bud onto the Unison colour soft pastel black. Just dappling that over the surface. As you can see, it gives quite a nice subtle shadows and details. Just dappling it, muting areas down that need to be muted. Using a fairly light hand with it, not going heavy whatsoever. Just darkening up that area up just to the right of my reflection. You can see from that the cotton bud itself does give a lovely bit of texture. Just picks out the highest points of the tooth in the pastel mark. Nice depth to the piece. Soften out the bottom of that shadow there. So as you can see now, I'm just blending out the eye into the skin, just framing the piece. This is ordinarily when you'd start to put your background down on a different subject. Just helps really getting the correct values, making sure everything's looking right tonal wise. So yeah, I'll just go around and fill in the darker areas just to give me a bit of a base to work from. just going in now with the light ultramarine 140 Fabri Castell pastel pencil. This is just to pick out the lightest areas in the reflection. Going in with the bistro now, just picking out a little bit more colour. Very much just a case, keep looking at your reference photo, put colour down where you think it needs to be down. Generally working darker to light, building up the layers, just softening out that black there. Obviously there was a slight transition between the colours, so add in that reflection. Just a very light layer of it, just a hint that the light is hitting that part of the eyeball. Just putting in a couple of imaginary lines there. I don't know what the hell I was doing with that, but again, just faffing around now with the ivory again. Just adding a few hints of detail, the little highlighted bits in the iris. This colour here is a Caran d'Ache pencil. I'm not at the minute exactly sure what it is, but I will find that out for you and put that in the description or the previous post about this piece. As you can see, just going along with the pencil, just trying to add a little bit more detail now, just scumbling across the surface, adding the light areas, just letting the tooth do the work still, just blending out a little bit more there. Trace paper blow my hand, obviously, to keep the work clean. Good bright bits there. Again, that's just very much a case of just slightly more pressure when laying the pencil down. It's already starting to look pretty much like an eye. And you have to think realistically, there's not been a great deal done. There's nothing to it at all. This is the Caran d'Ache pastel pencil 788035, and the colour is aqua. Again, I'm not sure if I've put that in my list. Oh no, I did. Yeah, no, that is in the list. So again, just drawing what I see, adding just hints of yellow here and there. Really light hand. Going back in with the flesh. What is it? The bloody find it. Where's it gone? I should be wearing my glasses. And I cannot see it on my list whatsoever. And the sodding hell is it? Medium flesh, 131. Got there in the end, better late than never. Just slowly going up into that dark area, just so it's a nice transition between lights and darks. Now for my favourite colour of all time, the Faber-Castell Pit Pastel. God, I can't bloody find it again. Where the hell is it? I wrote a list down. There we go. Olive green yellow 173. Can't read my own bloody writing. I find with this colour it's great for so many different pieces because it does just earth everything down no matter what you draw. And if you add a bit of this olive green, it will just mute it down and somehow it just makes something look a bit more realistic. So a little tip for you there, guys, if you want pieces to look fractionally more realistic, just put a tiny bit of green here and there. Going in now with the Faber-Castell cream. Again, my hand's looking awfully shaky. I think that is purely because I'm trying to keep the focus on the eye itself. And obviously, if my hand goes in front, more often than not, it does pull the focus out fractionally. Being super light with it. Just getting all them tiny little highlights in. Few random little lines and bits here and there. Looking at the reference photo, but not worrying too much, because at the end of the day, you'll never get it perfect, so have a bit of fun with it. Using the cotton bud here again, just to get the effect of detail. Using the Unison Colour Soft Pastel Black, CB2. Again, very much doing the same as what I did earlier in the video, just dappling it along the surface, muting colours down where I need to. Making slightly softer transitions between colours. Yeah, just adding detail without doing a great deal of work, to be honest. of the Faber-Castell Black Hair, reintroducing the darkest lines throughout the eye. A bit more shadowing towards the top there, coming back down around the iris. Yeah, just re-establishing my darkest areas. Going in now with the Faber-Castell Pit Pastel 1122193. The colour is burnt carmine. Going back in with that olive green. Muting the corner of the reflection down just a tad. Now the cotton bud's out again, this time just to blend out just fractionally. Obviously, if you don't have cotton buds, you can use a blending stump or a bit of tissue. Just anything with a similar sort of texture to that. Now I'm dappling on a bit of the Unison colour soft pastel, the Red Earth 17. Slowly softening that darker portion up. Now going in with the black soft pastel. This is very much just a base for the rest of the hairs around the eye. No finesse needed whatsoever. Just getting the black down. What I perceive to be the darkest areas of the drawing. Again, working generally in the direction of the fur. You don't really need to be accurate at this stage because you will be putting the hairs over the top of this. And just getting the cotton bud and just slowly softening that out. Re-putting that tape down, it comes slightly loose. Just pulling the pigment around the pastel mat, filling in the bulk of the grey. That is the colour of the pastel mat, by the way, the dark grey one. I do get quite a few people asking me what colour I prefer. I think that's nice just because it's a neutral value. So obviously you can work your lights and your darks on it and makes either or pop quite well. So they're still blending out that black. Top tip, guys, buy good quality masking tape. Obviously this stuff I'm using at the minute is not that great because I keep having to put the sodding stuff back down. So yeah, buy good masking tape. Now just going back in with the Bistra pencil. Basically now I'm just putting the undertones of colours I'm swapping on the first, so I will go in with a few different pencils and just pick out the base colours that I'm seeing below the black fur. Obviously wasn't quite happy with the position of the corner of the eye there, so I just erased that. Going back in with the Faber-Castell black pencil. Tweaking that shape just a tad, erasing that area again. Now going back in with a bit of the ivory. You'll have to excuse me knocking the camera there, I'll keep headbutting it. I hope you're all still awake, by the way. I think we must be about an hour in now. Just adding a very light layer of that just along, so I can see roughly where the top of the eye is when I'm adding my hair details. bit more of that olive green here. Now going back in with the black again, just to reintroduce the darkest areas of the piece. A little bit more darkness just on top of the reflection there. Just adding the hint of the oil ashes now in the reflection. It's not quite as easy with a pencil that short, but obviously if you have got a razor sharp pencil, it does help massively. Good fast, quick strokes with this. Bit more darkness there, just scrambling across. Now going in with the Unison colour white soft pastel, and this is just really get the highlights popping. Just putting them where I see the lightest parts of the drawing. That black again, I'm still not quite happy with the shape of the corner. A few more highlights near the tear duct. Cream. Again, just softening that area down a bit. Still a very light hand. Lightening up areas where I need to be, darkening up the other areas. just here, guys, please don't worry about getting every detail perfect. I mean, at the end of the day, it's a reflection in the eye. And you know, it would be silly to try and get everything super, super detailed. You can see just what I've done there. It's more than good enough. Just gives you an idea of what's going on, sort of thing. Just adding some of that olive yellowish green now. Just muting that white area down just a fraction. Just below the eye. You can see in a reference photo it is slightly darker just under the actual eye itself. So softening that black line out with the bistro. A little more up towards where it will be darker. Pretty siren behind there. A little bit of black there. Slight bit of shadowing from the details in the eyeball. Going in now with my watercolour brush pen. Any soft bristled brush is fine to use. This one looks worse for wear, but it still does the job, so. This is just softening out areas where you can't really see a great deal of sharpness. And I think, to be honest, that's pretty much the base layers down for the eye. So the next section, we should be starting to look more at the fur around the eye and then going back and adding details to the eye. I hope you're all still awake or not completely pissed yet. I hope everyone's had a good day and relaxing now. Hopefully by the time this video's uploaded, I'll be sat with a nice pint. So we'll be looking forward to that. Just softening that shadow out there. And then this is a point where I did notice that the reflection of me needed to be a fraction larger. So here I am just going around, making that just a tad bit bigger. Obviously that would be my phone there. Though it's that small, you don't need to worry about getting a huge amount of detail. Really getting my darkest areas dark there. Nice bit of pressure. Bloody car revving as he goes past. Not bad. Getting a bit of a darker look there. Really getting the darkest areas as dark as I can, making areas look that little bit sharper, adding a slight bit more curve to the eye. I wasn't quite happy with how it was sitting, so I did just add just a fraction more black just to the right side, just to make it a bit more accurate in shape. You can see that line wasn't quite in the right place, so I've just added more black. Getting the shape as near as I can. Still not happy with that bit. Back in, obviously because I've not worked too heavily in that area, I can get away with erasing a few times. It's only really when you're using a heavy hand that you'll struggle to do bits like that. So now, very loosely, getting the direction of the hairs down. Short, sharp and fast. Obviously Staffordshire Bull Terriers fur is naturally, you know, they're short haired dogs, so you want to be making sure you're getting the accuracy of the length of the hairs and the direction. If you can get that right, everything else is pretty much super easy to do. Just touching up colours there. Obviously because I pulled the eye a fraction more, I've just added a bit more colour to that section. Going back in, that is real time at the minute, so you know, just looking at that, you really don't need to be worrying about details. It's just getting the first layer down, putting the hairs down the direction that they're flowing in. Do that all over the drawing, which I should start to do in a second. Bloody hands in the way. Obviously that is the Faber-Castell black pastel pencil, by the way. So you can see now, look, we would if I actually had a decent sized pencil. I don't want no funny comments there either. And then, yeah, just getting getting the hairs down in the direction. Obviously, they're very short, right near the eye, along the eye, so you want to be keeping a lookout for that. You know, don't guess the length of the hairs. You want to be accurate in that sense. Still working in the direction that the hairs are flowing in. Really not a great deal to it. Shouldn't take you too long. This is the base layer, remember, so don't panic if you've got a couple of hairs that are not perfectly right. Plenty of time to work over them. So. Not far off having that pretty much done. First layer is about there. Going in now, just adding all the final details to the iris and pupil. Bit of white there. Yeah, you see the next few minutes, I'll just go over them. Detail areas where it needs to be. Bit more of the light ultramarine there. Defining that head shape a bit more in the reflection. Getting that body nice and black. Curve of the where the reflection is in the middle of the eye there, just bending down more. Yeah, it's just basically just refining what I've done, working over, just adding small details. You'll see in the next few minutes, so enjoy. Just slimming the waist of my body down in this part, as I'm not quite as fat as I looked on it before. That's just using the Faber-Castell cream. If you're working along, guys, obviously feel free to slow it down or speed it up or whatnot. Although I'd imagine most of you are probably just sat with a nice glass of wine or a can of beer at the minute. As you can see, just adding small details here and there. Just getting the finishing bits done to the eye. Thank you to anybody who is still awake. I appreciate it hugely. I know it is quite a long video, but I am hoping in the future to keep them around the hour mark. I think with this one, even though it's an alright video, it is a bloody long time to be watching the same thing. So, but then I guess if you are drawing along, then it will make it a bit more manageable for you all. A bit more black going down there. You know, if you are following along, please be looking at the reference photo as much as what I'm doing, because ultimately I'm working from the reference photo. So you will get a more accurate rendition by doing the same. I think really your best bet's just to use this as a guideline. Going in there with the Caran Dash 788066, the raw russet. Just pulling that red out a fraction more. And I'm still using a very light hand. I do find for detailing like this, it's definitely beneficial just to be as light as you can. I mean, not so much around like what I'm doing now, when, you know, where there's really dark areas. But for the actual lighter details, I do think a lighter hand is the way forward. Just going in there with the Unison colour, soft pastel black. I wasn't quite happy with how light that still was, so getting a bit more of that down. As I say, guys, I will find out what colour this pastel pencil is and put it in the description below the link once posted. going in now with the watercolour brush, just to soften out the highlights up towards more shadowed areas. And then now the Caran d'Ache Aqua, very much just doing dots here. I mean, it's a good solid pigment, so it will show through in the final piece. Now the scarlet red, an ultra light hand at this stage. You can just see it just above the black. Real light hand, guys. Getting a bit of that helio turquoise down now. And obviously, because it is a reflection, there will be, you know, a half decent amount of blue in there. So just makes it pop that little bit more. A little bit more black just on the inside of it. softening out a bit of that black with the earbud and my finger. He roars perfectly fine. Getting a bit of the turquoise colour down now in the fur. Basically just picking out any colours that I'm seeing before going with my white pencil. Just so I know I've got a good base to work from and that the colours will show through in the end piece. Now the 193 burnt carmine. Now just going in with the Faber-Castell Pastel White pencil. This is very much just getting the short white grey hairs. Obviously they look grey, but using a white pencil they come out sort of grey looking. Just doing this all over the whole piece, following the direction of the fur. I did speed this bit up by 5 because it is very much me just doing what I'm doing now all over the piece. Also, a good sharp pencil is suggested. I mean, mine's not too sharp at the minute, but it will make your life a lot easier if it's sharp. as you can see in the corner here, I did do the hairs longer because as they come out towards the bottom of his cheek, they are slightly longer than the hairs that are below and around his eye. So please make sure you look at the reference photo when putting these hairs down. Please don't worry when putting these hairs down, guys, about getting 100% accuracy. I mean, it'd be bad enough on a large scale, but at 6x6, it would be nearly impossible. So all you're really doing is just getting a similar position of the hairs. As long as they're going in the right direction, the right length, they will look accurate. So yeah, don't lose any sleep over that. Just looking at the reference photo here, seeing where the brightest hairs are on the piece. Obviously they are all quite short generally, so yeah, it's just randomly picking out where there's a few good bright hairs and yeah, just adding a bit of depth to it. Just going in with a few more longer white hairs here. Obviously I think this would be where his eyebrow would be, so they are generally a bit longer than around his eye. As you can see, just adding slightly more pressure to get these brighter hairs. I mean, like I say, you really do want to be using a sharp pencil. My pencil's not really sharp enough for this, but at this stage, good sharp pencil and a good amount of pressure and you'll get a nice solid hair. pretending a few more of the highlights in the corner of the eye near the tear duct. Obviously, you'll notice just before that, when doing the eyelashes, if you do a quick sharp motion, you will always get a more feathered look rather than slow. So if you want good, short, strong looking sharp hairs, flick your pencil fast. Just going in now and re-establishing my black areas. Obviously, you will notice that I've gone over the whole piece and just add, you know, just pulling out a few more of the shadows in between all the highlighted hairs. And I think I do go all over the piece and just randomly add a few more bits. That is the black Faber-Castell pastel pencil I'm using there. Obviously it's that small, you can't see it because my bloody fingers are in the way. was going in with the bistro, basically just putting a slight wash over areas just so a bit of that colour is still pulling through. I think I do it with one of the reddy tones as well, possibly the blue. But yeah, basically I'm just pretty much a bit of a glaze over the whites just to mute the areas and keep the highlighted areas looking a little bit more 3D. A bit of the olive yellowish green now. Yeah, basically just again same thing, just mute it down, just helps, gives it that hint of realism. Alright guys, we're coming towards the end now. I've got the slice tool. I'm not exactly sure which model it is, but to be honest, any craft knife would work fine. But please be careful, as obviously they are extremely sharp and you don't want to be cutting into your pastel mat while working. So now basically just going over, adding any blemishes I see, all the small details that your pencil just can't quite pick out. All the blemishes in the skin, you know, they are quality bits of kit for getting real small details. Just going across, you can see there, look, just getting a few tiny little hairs. Picking out details as I see them. I pretty much do this throughout, you know, just go over the whole piece and just add bits here and there. You can see me softening the areas down. Going over, and that in itself is almost adding underlying hairs below the highlighted hairs. It's a really good, you know, really good tip, good bit of kit to use, and just gives you that final sort of look to the piece, the finished look. So yeah, I'll just carry on doing this. Just this for a while, and I think I do go back in with some pencils shortly. So yeah, just enjoy this process and see how I'm using the knife, just gently, just real small hairs, just tiny little details. few details just around the tear duct now. Just going over, just looking at my reference photo as I go. Now these bits on the video, they do look really bright, but in real life they're nowhere near as harsh as how they look there. I don't know why, I don't know why the camera's picked them out to be so bright, but they're nowhere near as vivid. Obviously you'll see on the photo that comes up at the end, that is how they look. So, you know, please don't panic and think, oh, of course, they're way too bright. They're not. They just look it on this camera. Just adding a little bit more there, just to that reflective area. It's basically, you're just looking at the drawing. You know, you just try and replicate roughly what goes where. A few more little tiny hairs here and there, and go over the old piece like that. Remember, not worrying too much about getting things stupidly accurate, because it's just pointless. If you can get the illusion of accuracy, that's more than good enough. Just now going in with a few different pencils, just to pull a bit of that colour back, and a few more hairs there. That is the Faber-Castell cream. What colour is it? Obviously they've all been listed. It's cream 102, but they are all listed in the previous post below this video, so if you can't remember which is which, please feel free to have a look. Yeah, basically just do this with a few different pencils, just re-establishing a few of the different colours that are showing through in his fur. And that's all there is to it. So as you can see, guys, I am pretty much finishing up now. I've just gone over with all the pencils I've used throughout the piece, just refining little areas here and there, adding all the finishing touches and whatnot. Added a bit more blue to the eyes, and yeah, it's just the final touches, basically. I did, after this video, spend another 5 minutes adding just a little bit more detail and highlighted areas. The reason for this is basically because when I record, the camera is where my head would naturally be, so it is very hard to get detail when I'm not in a natural position. Basically just went over with a Unison colour, soft pastel, white. Just pulled out a few more highlights, cleaned up a few of the areas. You'll see in the final photo sort of thing. Just a few minutes worth just to clean it up. So, bloody car behind me. Christ almighty, that all day and they make a sodding racket when I'm recording. Anyway, guys, I really hope you've enjoyed the video and you've picked up a few tips and learned something. If not, then I'm sure it's probably sent you to sleep. So, yeah, thank you very much for your support, by the way. I do appreciate it. And that sodding car's just come back. I hope you've enjoyed it, everyone. Any questions or anything, please feel free, send me a message or let me know in the comments below. I want to go and crack myself open a beer now and relax for the rest of the evening. Hope everyone has a fantastic weekend, and I should be posting a video next week. Any suggestions for that, again, feel free to message me a comment. Alright, guys, hope you've enjoyed. Ciao for now.